Hey guys, welcome to my channel. My name is Sandy Foskett and I'm here to teach you makeup. So, a few people have asked me how to do makeup. They're like, I don't even know where to start. So, I thought I'd start from the beginning. In my first video, I'm going to teach you guys how to do foundation. So, basically, moisturize. That's like the number one thing you can do. Yeah, moisturize. So if you don't moisturize, your skin probably will dry out just because some of the makeup products can be really drying to your skin. Often like liquid foundation stuff can be really like harsh, especially if you have dry skin already. So I like to use Cetaphil. You can pick this up for real cheap, about $9 from Priceline or Kohl's or anywhere really. So what you're going to do, you're going to take a little bit and you're just gonna spread it on all parts of your face. You really want to make sure that your skin is really clean and your hands really clean before you start doing any makeup, just because otherwise you're gonna have bacteria all over your face and that's pretty gross. Yeah, so if you're in a rush and you don't have a lot of time to get ready and stuff, a really quick way you can do this is just get a tissue and just pat over your face. But yeah, it rushes a bit, so just let it sink in. Now that our moisturizer is dried, we're gonna go in with some primer. So this one is the Rimmel London Stay Matte Primer. It's actually really cheap and I think I picked it up for about $13. It's, yeah, good value for money. It really gets, I know, into your pores. So the purpose of wearing primer is so that your skin comes like airbrushed, especially around your nose. You're gonna see that you have a lot of like blackheads or pores or whatever. And you just wanna put primer all over that so you can't see massive holes in your face. You're gonna take about that much just for one side of your face. So whenever you're doing makeup, you really want to start in the middle of your face, so around the bridge of your nose. And then you want to go for the other side of your face. And just on your chin, I'm just blending it all out. Okay, so you're gonna want to let that set in as well, let the layers dry one by one, otherwise it's like, you know, wet nail polish. You don't leave the whole thing to dry, then you're just gonna put your hand on top of it and it's all gonna come off, and yeah, it's really lame. Primer is also used to keep your makeup in place. Yeah, so it just kind of stops everything from shifting throughout the day. Wanna do, so you lay that for 2 minutes, something like that, just let it go, but I'll talk to you in the meantime. So you're gonna wanna pick a foundation. So before you even decide whether you wanna press powder or whatever, you want to figure out if you're yellow or rose tone. So, I am probably a neutral. I'm not too yellow. So an easy way to figure out whether you're yellow or rose is just look at your veins about here. So if they're really blue, then yeah, you're pink toned. If they're green, then you're yellow. If you're somewhere blue or green in between, you're probably neutral and most things are going to go with your face. Okay, so there's a few different things. So I have this Helen Rubinstein palette, so that's got a pressed powder foundation. So yeah, pressed powder foundation, just, if you're looking for powder, just buy whatever. I have this cheap BYS stuff I used to use, but I will show you how to use that as well. And then I also have this Stay Matte foundation, so it's more of a cream. Like, if you're not a fan of having stuff on your face, I suggest go with the powder first because it's very light. If you're into something a bit heavier, Estee Lauder Double Wear is like Jesus. Oh my gosh. Anyway, so I'll show you with the Helen Rubinstein palette first. So just gonna take a MAC brush, 168 SE, and you take the powder, and you always, like I was telling you before, work from the inside out. So we're just working down across your nose and outwards. Let's embrace the point of no return. Same thing goes with your loose powder. Just take a bit. I like to stick it in the lid just so I don't get too much product. Let go, we can free ourselves of all we've learned. I love the secret. So these like get really light coverage. I'll show you with something a bit heavier now on the other side of my face. So we'll start with the same app. I like to use the back of my hand as a palette, so just squeeze a tiny bit on, about that much will do plenty. Cut it like this. And then I like to dab it on, just so it doesn't come across too cakey. So yeah, when you're selecting foundation, it's really important that you find the color that suits your face, because if you get too dark, you're gonna look like a Cheeto, and if you get too light, you'll probably end up looking like Edward Cullen or something. So yeah, just you wanna test it out on your neck. And that brings me to my next point. You have to make sure you blend everything into your neck, otherwise you are going to look ridiculous. Like, your head will probably be all orange and it will be quite funny. So my tip for blending into your neck is just wanna grab a little bit of foundation, and you wanna grab some of your moisturizer, just stick a bit on top, and then you're just gonna mix it all together on your hand, and then you've got a really easy way to stick it on your neck. Language that was speaking. So this brings me to my last product, Estee Lauder Double Wear. This is pretty heavy duty stuff. Unfortunately, it doesn't come with a pump or anything, so you're kind of just gonna stick it and hope that it doesn't go everywhere. So that's probably plenty. So this is a MAC 133 SE brush. It's a bit flat foundation brush. Yeah, so you just take a bit and just starting from the inside, work it all the way out. In regards to the setting of the powder, yeah, just grab, I usually use just the Helen Rubinstein again, and just paint that all over my face. Yeah, you don't have to use a brush, but it's a lot more hygienic, and I think if you're using liquid foundation, you probably struggle a lot to use it without a brush. You can pick them up for real cheap from what's it called? I don't know. Priceline. You can buy like cheap like designer brands or something. If you're not really into spending a lot of money, it doesn't really matter that much. Like, these MAC brushes are very expensive, so if you're just starting out and you don't really short to get, I would recommend just getting whatever you can find in Priceline, because you don't really know what you're gonna like or not like, and just test everything out. So yeah, I'm gonna finish this makeup look and I'll be back. Yeah, I just put a bit of Wild Clover from Rimmel London lip liner all over my lips and just blended it in, and this is my look. Is this the part where I make funny faces at the camera? Yeah, so I know that's a pretty weird video. Anyway, see you guys.